Tesla Giga Berlin has a new supplier partner from the Polish subsidiary of Israel's Electro Group, which strikes $80 million contract with Tesla. Polish subsidiary Electra M&E Polska will perform electromechanical work for Tesla Electric Vehicle Corporation at its new plant at Tesla Giga Berlin. Welcome back, dear friends. This is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. If you are here first time and would like to receive daily Tesla news, please subscribe to our channel and ring the bell not to miss my next Tesla story. We bring several Tesla stories here on this channel daily. So Israel's Electra Group strikes $80 million with Tesla to perform electromechanical work for Tesla at the Giga Berlin. The deal, like I said, it's $80 million. This reports Calcalist.com. The work will take place in Tesla's new factory that is currently being built near German capital Berlin in Kuhnheide. It is Tesla's fourth Gigafactory, fourth plant in the world, and its first in Europe. We are proud to be a partner in a strategic agreement with a groundbreaking company like Tesla and see it as a significant milestone in Electra's position as a leading player in the electromechanical field in Europe, said Itamar Deutscher, CEO of Electra Ltd. The new factory outside Berlin, the Giga Berlin, is set to manufacture Tesla's Model Y electric vehicle. Electra M&E Polska recently completed electromechanical project for German car manufacturing giants like Volkswagen, Audi, and Mercedes, and deals reaching more than $75 million. And this one is $80 million only for Tesla at Tesla Giga Berlin. This collaboration joins a series of agreements that Electra has signed in the last 2 years to perform electromechanical work for leading car companies in Europe, added Deutscher. The technological knowledge and many years of experience that Electra has gained in managing works in this field will allow us to express all the group's abilities and skills at the highest level of workmanship and quality. So you can see this company is going to be the company that is going to provide electromechanical work at Tesla's Giga Berlin, probably connecting things together, connecting equipment together. Friends, it's very interesting that this is the Polish subsidiary of an Israeli group, because from Poland, I have had a report that there will be probably big flux of businesses and influx of businesses and workers coming to work at Giga Berlin, because Tesla Giga Berlin factory is very close to the Polish border. And recently I even discussed about a city on the border from where a lot of people, maybe thousands or hundreds of workers will come, because Tesla Giga Berlin is going to employ about at its last stage at its with phase two up to 12,000 people. And and Grünheide, where Giga Berlin is located, is a very small municipality of about 8,500 people. People are going to come from brown cities. There's going to be an influx of talent to the area, including from Poland. And it is not surprising that a Polish company is going to do electromechanical, Polish-Israeli company is going to do electromechanical work with Tesla, which is worth of $80 million. So speaking of Giga Berlin, you know, today at Giga Berlin, there are lots of fans and opponents gathered to meet and greet Tesla CEO Elon Musk, who is in Germany today. And they were expecting him yesterday, but apparently because of his busy schedule, he couldn't come. What I'm looking for is not just for a coming of a CEO, but I personally am looking to come to see what announcement Tesla CEO Elon Musk will make while at Giga Berlin, because there is been a lot of excitement in Giga Berlin. Giga Berlin has changed the landscape of German automotive industry, because in Germany, the majority of automotive companies and factories are generally located in south, and Giga Berlin is one of the major first automotive companies to Tesla to establish something in the northern part. So that's going to change the landscape. That's going to bring 12,000 jobs to the area. That's going to change the lives of thousands of people, and also change the economy economy of Germany somewhat in a positive way, and also the environment positive, hopefully with positive impact on our environment. Although the opponents that I mentioned that are gathered there today and yesterday are concerned about the groundwater, because it's a groundwater preservation area in Germany. So there is a lot of excitement going on there. And yesterday Elon Musk met with German ministers as Tesla appeared to make a push for the German energy market, a move that could set the stage for the company to take on established utilities in Europe's biggest power market, Reuters reported. And state politicians at the Giga Berlin location actually got to see the Tesla CEO Elon Musk in person, like I reported yesterday on Wednesday in the afternoon. Yesterday afternoon, the Brandenburg State Chancellery published a photo on Twitter with Musk, as well as Prime Minister Dietmar Woidke and Economics Minister Jörg Steinbach of Brandenburg. Further information about this meeting was not disclosed. The two Brandenburg politicians, like Altmaier, have repeatedly emphasized for the federal government how important they consider Tesla's German project to be, how important for them is Tesla Giga Berlin. Steinbach then thanked Musk for Twitter on Twitter for visit, as I reported yesterday. And so in the meantime, the supporters of Tesla Giga Berlin, who have been in the rain at the Gigafactory construction site since the morning, were initially disappointed, because they were hoping that Elon Musk would visit Giga Berlin yesterday, which was also confirmed by a Tesla employee, our reporter friends report from Giga Berlin. But toward the evening, they left their posts along with a few demonstrators. At least one of them held out until sunset, but could no longer report the Tesla CEO arriving. As the RBB reports, a topping out ceremony is now planned for this Friday, and Elon Musk participation is quite possible. That means Elon Musk will be in Berlin for 3 days. He has been in Europe basically this entire week, flying with his jet. But he arrived to Berlin yesterday, so today is Thursday, and the topping out ceremony is now planned for the Friday. Because this is important, because Tesla Giga Berlin didn't have an official groundbreaking ceremony. So this may be a good thing. At least on Wednesday, preparations for an event seemed to continue on site after a delivery of event technology. A flower delivery van was also seen on the site, and our friends are reporting today that there is a security there. So maybe Elon Musk will come today, or maybe he will have some meetings in Berlin or meeting with other officials and come tomorrow. But we'll see. We'll keep an eye on that, and if he comes and makes an important announcement, I will report on this channel. In the meantime, friends, this is Armin Haryan from TorqueNews.com. Please subscribe to our channel if you are here first time and would like to receive daily Tesla news. And I'll see you in our next report. God bless you. Take good care of each other. Stay safe, and see you soon in our next report.